possibility to have our own program and award. This was a similar thing which I was describing. Now, the NERIST, since its inception, was innovative project under NEC, Healthy Partner System of Education, where we had provision of admitting students just after class 10, sir, having 2 years module, base module 2 years, diploma module 2 years, and degree module 2 years. And it was of its own time. And then we had multiple entry and multiple exit as well. In other words, we had possibility to receive students after 10 plus 2 directly to diploma module, as well as we have also possibility to admit students after diploma program through lateral entry. And for these three steps of entry, we conduct our entrance examination, basic science, technology, and management as well. And then we have yearly programs in other departments. Basically, we have six uni programs in engineering, and our programs are MBA accredited. MBA in pharmacy, the respective departments of engineering have MBA programs. And then we have Master of Science in Forestry, Physics, Chemistry, Mathematics, and MBA. Locally to meet with the growing need of trained manpower and execution of various development projects, to provide institutional facilities for the growth of instituted another single institution, Central Institute of Technology, Kukradhari, Assam, and Sangrur, Sleep, and Gani Khachodri Institute of Engineering Board of Management. And the president of the society is none other than His Excellency, the Governor of us, including HRD, Vijay's Joint Secretary, and the Joint Secretary of Finance. So this constitutes our board of
members. Sirs, come.
Sir.
Do these officers come regularly?
Yes.
Last time we have been king, last week.
Our consultancy is our service. We are because and because we are the industry around in the state. So.
Right.
And sir, the sponsoring agencies are shown here. So, in fact, in addition to MHRD fellowship, we do get grant and other grants we are able to provide.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Does anybody from CSIR, ICMR, they visit here? ISRO?
Sir, sometimes when we have evaluation committees, so we do get some advisors from DVT department.
AACT, how often is their interaction?
We have very close interaction, and it is proud for us when the present chairman of AACT, Professor Adil Sarasimhe, had been our senior colleague here this time in his career.
What about the international agencies, UNDP, UNESCO? Do you have any connection with them?
Not with them directly, sir, but then we, some of our faculty and the students had been abroad under exchange program through Indian National Science Academy and academies of UK, Hungary, Poland, Germany, then United States.
Do you have students from outside?
No, sir, not.
In the... Acha. What is the ratio between the Northeast students as well as the rest of India?
It is 90 to 10%.
90 local?
90 Northeast.
10 from outside. Within the Northeast, the every state is showing interest, students?
Yes, sir. Actually, this was one of the most accepted institution. But then now, each states are given NITs, and IITs have also come to existence. So those who are getting NITs are their own home state, so they do not prefer.
So Nagaland, for example, how many students you have?
Sir, we have students actually, we admit at base model. So 20 students are admitted each year.
They're coming.
They are coming. And sir, this is publication.
Publications roughly you have? How many publications to your credit?
Sir, this is...
Total together. By your institute, which is in practice or which has become beneficial to the northeastern states, because the very idea of setting up the institute here is to train people to tap the resources or meet the challenges of the Northeast.
Just 2 minutes after.
Right.
For our research.
Okay.
Selected research out. So, these are some things that we have put by for the students. It was supported by Northeast and then we are in idea of the book and division and then for the improvement programs. Particularly members in the government program has expressed in 5 hours. There is a unique part. It's a deployed average to very facility for medical treatment and free internet, email facility, and online case payments.
Okay.
And, sir, the very last year, we had the central library, which came into existence, and it was targeted by our honorable Home Business State, our state producer. And now it is over the contents, we have about 16,000 books. The volumes are 63,065 altogether, and then 9 million centers. So it is a good facility in the sense of the past. Sir, these are a few laboratory infrastructures for various departments just to share with you. Dairy and food technology, pharmacy, and then food processing engineering and soil and water engineering. Then in mechanical engineering, we have dynamic machinery lab, gas dynamics lab, and biodiesel lab, and computer aided manufacturing and automation lab. And in electrical engineering, we have circuit and measurement lab, control and instrumentation lab, electrical machine lab, and then power system and protection lab. In electronics and communication, digital signal processing lab, communication lab, system lab, microprocessor, hardware lab. So these are in policy, we have plant, bio-growing lab, and biotechnology lab, policy system, and then agriculture, and civil culture, and besides that, sir, we, the Department of Agriculture Engineering, sometimes we organize Kisan Mela, and then we share with the farmers who join our program with the inventions which you are asking leaders right now. The agriculture engineering, and particularly our ergonomics faculty members are quite active, and some of the slides are shown here. And here, so this is the some social activities and the same agriculture engineering department, they have developed some improved self-armora road, which is quite commonly practiced in a branch of this and other reasons.
Right.
This is a remote control power filler. This is developed by our one of the technology in agriculture engineering. So it is shown here, visible.
Is it being used?
Yes, we have.
Not in the lab, by the farmers.
But they have come out with this option. Sir, regarding hospital facility, we are fully residential, so it is mandatory for us to provide hospital accommodation to all the
1782.
So we have 1782.
Okay.
And recreational and creative activity forum and sports activity.
Right.
Sir, and NCC and NSS are part of our curriculum, and we also give them great for these activities.
Right.
So under the track of the students have all these activities, and for the sports and games, we do organize annual sports meet, and they participate in all the activities. Sir, we have also NCC,
and NSS, optional program, either NCC or NSS. So our students are shown here during the public day parade. These are some NSS activities. The bottom side is flood donation activity. And,
maybe 20 years. So 20 years plus 1971 means 59 plus 18 years, that means 74. Buildings are intact. Stone, Visakhapatnam, university blocks.
Sir, here's why the texture is a little different. I mean, we have seen it in the zone and the extent without some attack. I mean,
we don't have a stone at all here, that's another problem. Okay, next.
Sir, we also have provision of technical education means academic calendar. So, the system of education was, we had, as the chief guest, we had the excellency, the governor. This was a silver jubilee celebration at that time we had the
Right.
And, sir, we, in addition to our academic program and following NSS, NCC activities, sports education facilities, we also support the surrounding villages and other programs. So, sir, this is one program where one NGO, they came to train some village women, where I supported them in our IOM under Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas.
Go ahead, good speed. See, I am more interested in knowing the very purpose of setting up this institute is to take care and bridge the gap, techno-management gap between rest of the country and Northeast. To what extent some work has been done. Secondly, any innovations done here which are being used for the betterment of this region. Thirdly, the people who are working here in the lab, are they in touch with the general people? Once in a way, holding Mela is different. Are the students who are doing research, are they visiting the field? How much time they are spending? Is it part of their academic activity and also gradation of the marks? On such things, if you have to throw some light, these are all normal things. Anybody, any college will be doing it. I am not that much concerned about it.
NERIST has been successfully doing the job for which it was instituted, because we are receiving students from all the 8 Northeast states, largely 90%, and we have been imparting very good education, and our students are very well accepted, not only within the region, not only within the country, but they have shown their presence internationally also, as a faculty member and postdoctoral fellow, and involving us to companies. So that way, sir, I think your high
now, what is your innovation? Yeah, quickly, go ahead, go to that. These are all side effect, side activities, na? These are all okay. Doing yoga, good. So I am going around the country for information. I am going around the country to see different research institutes, understand what is happening, what are the challenges they are facing, not the problems. Problems are routine, there will be some gap here and there. Challenges they are facing and what is the contribution they have made, how best they can be improved further. This is the part of my mission across the country.
So, sir, under your emphasis of research and innovation, I submit here, we have selected three speakers. I am one of them, so I start with my presentation here. Sir, actually, I have some collaborative work because we have time constraints, so I will briefly tell you and share you. Here the biodiversity and particularly the plant resources and the green vegetables and fruits are abundant, quite abundant. And the peroxidases are present in all the plants, parts, green plants.
18,
sir, but then the point is that we have to identify which plant are part of the plant, are vegetable, are fruit, is rich source of peroxidase, which can be harnessed for industrial importance and public use. So in that context, sir, why is our research group we have come out with, I'm not going to be production of peroxidase.
Not necessary.
I just come directly to the point, and I also ignore the fine details of the.
Professor, you are going into subject. I am asking you what has been done, what is the result. You are trying to, you because of, you have the time constraint, what is substantial has been done.
Sir, this is
a
complementary study of activities, and the peroxidase can be used for organic transformations like the household and domestic effluents. We have different types of phenolic compounds by virtue of using cosmetics and some other origins. So those phenolics can be converted within green chemistry domain to the phenones, and having phenones in place, then the absorption process becomes easy. So, sir, we are planning to design a domestic digester where most of the time the bark of the vegetables or fruits we throw out in the dustbin. So, that bark or waste material of the green vegetables and fruits can be put in a digester, a small digester. And then little quantity of hydrogen peroxide should be added. And then it will convert all the phenolic compounds which are harmful to the environment into the respective ketones. And then by putting the charcoal can be used, even the bamboo charcoal can be used, which is being used in the domestic purpose in the villages. And that can have a manifold absorption. And therefore, the effluent going out of the domestic drains will be much safer for the environment. So, sir, this is.
This is being done.
Yes. So results are already done. Now the design of digester is under process. We will come out for patent and
Right.
other things.
Go ahead.
Soon.
Okay, one.
And, sir, in addition to this, I again, sir, come to this is chemistry part I am giving. Sir, the beauty of this cucumber is that the pH for which the peroxidase is found in the cucumber is 7. So very close to neutral. So it is very eco-friendly. And then the optimum temperature is 25 degrees C, which is normal temperature. So there is no additional effort required to have this digester successful. Now I give this part, sir. And we have also completed with all these phenolic compounds and the engineering containing derivatives. So our experiments are successful. We have also conducted cyclic voltammetry studies to work out the potential window. Which is very favorable and lower potential is helpful to obtain such conversion. So, sir, it is already experimentally completed and the potentials are also given. I ignore all these things, sir. I have shared with you the summary. Sir, I would like to mention that during my collaboration with Indian National Science Academy, through Indian National Science Academy research program with Hungarian and Polish Academy of Science, we had a similar catalyst selenium based for such conversion and synthesis of vitamin K3. But those conversions are possible with the peroxidase which we are exploring here with the fruits and vegetables. And
right.
I am going to show you, sir, another outcome. This was also under collaboration of Foreign and Commonwealth Fellowship by British Council. We had this elegant polygon. The work as a catalyst is polygon for far. We can achieve the similar conversion using our peroxidase, which is available in the fruits and vegetables which are available here. So this we have done.
Right.
And sir, this is another this leaf guard, a Rufa rectangula, is also very rich source of peroxidase and commonly used as vegetable here locally and can be used in our biodigester or the domestic digester, which is on the way to conclude very soon, sir.
Right.
And in addition to this, there is one more species of green vegetables, Rufa cylindrica, which we call it in our language, and we call it in our language. That is also a very outstanding source of peroxidase, and our research experiments are successful for conversion of phenolic compounds to phenol.
Right.
So, sir, these are the experimental data,
right.
And along with the scientific world, right.
The other one, climate change.
I believe my name is speaker. Dr. Adini Bhadra. Dr. Adini Bhadra. Sir, before I conclude, I think just a minute to say that now all the scientific community, I think ecologists must focus to make a theme for global transformation within green chemistry domain for clean and green earth. This is the message of why NERIST, why us, in the presence of Honorable Vice President.
Thank you. Next, Professor Bhadra.
Yes, sir.
Tell me. You try to understand, I think by this time you would have understood. I do not want history, I do not want theory. They're all good, important. What is it that has been achieved by this institute for the betterment of the life of the people in this area? Whether it is innovation, whether it is value addition, whether it is some technological innovation, on such things, what is the advice you have given and how people are benefited? Please do not, ma'am, please do not read. I'm trying, time and again I'm saying, in concrete, this has been taken up, this is completed, this is the result, this is being used by X, Y, Z. If you just read, no, it's there in the book. I can read myself, no?
Change in total runoff that was observed, that in 2050 it is reducing a little bit, but in 2080 it is increasing a
Yeah, this is the that sort of conclusions. Yeah. This is the conclusion of your study. That
and
will be useful.
Also, Egypt is spatially distributed snowball have a model for Aurora watershed. As it is seasonally snow covered, so what we got that rain induced contribution is about more than 85%, and snow induced runoff is less than 15%. So as it is seasonally snow covered, so contribution of rain is more compared to snow.
Snow, right.
And these are, we are working on, so the result we will get. So these are some of the papers finding we got, that these are the papers we published in different journals, that variation of snow albedo in upper elevation zone of Abu Basin, spatial temporal joint analysis. So now I want to highlight the recent involvement of NERIST on climate change and its implication in Arunachal Pradesh. Recently, NERIST has launched a program, Human and Institutional Capacity Building, HICAP, in Climate Change for Indian Himalayan Region. They have identified different sub-themes, and NERIST is capable to do research under each of the sub-themes. And NERIST was also identified by NERIST as a potential institute in Arunachal Pradesh. So we are going to conduct a meeting in the next week, 19 June. We will conduct a meeting with potential network partners of Arunachal Pradesh, and we will formulate a network program in climate change and Himalayan ecosystem for Arunachal Pradesh. We have
right.
already invited different persons, the director and head of the organizations of different university institute and organization of Arunachal Pradesh. So in the 19 June, we will do the meeting.
Right.
And also, NERIST will participate in upcoming VCs and directors roundtable meeting in New Delhi to express interest and potential to become the center of excellence in climate change for Arunachal Pradesh and coordinator of network program in climate change for Arunachal Pradesh. So
right.
we are hopeful that in future we will play a greater role
right.
in climate change.
Go to next, Dr. Pradeep Kumar, antimicrobials. You have understood now what is my yeah, please. With this, concluded, what is the next stage? My point is that you are talking of the next work. What you have already invented or found or came to conclusion, what is the follow-up? Who is going to use this? Your knowledge which you have produced, or the innovations you have done, or inventions you have found? Really, this is a good work, but at the same time, unless it's used by somebody or followed it up, mere research confining to books is not going to be of much use. Okay.
And sir, by using the bioinformatics tools, we reported that the model was earlier than the cell model in plant genome. And I also reported one disease that is caused in a plant, that is association of phytoplasma with the epiphyllida. And these days, phytoplasma is one of the major cause of reduction of crop production. So we identify the marker for the early detection of this phytoplasma. And similarly, I worked with some mango malformation pathogen detection, which is one of the most deleterious cause for the mango production reduction in the area. And this is our proposal that we are going to use this proposal, our proposed work in near future for the development of antiviral product against maybe some Zika virus and some other kind of virus. And then we already published this result in critical review in biotechnology. And these are the some results I have shown that Lassen-Sinhal and Garum crop, how they are going to react on the bacterial infection in the human. And I'm also trying to work on the aflatoxin. This is one of the major problems in all over the world. So we are trying to find out, because this aflatoxin causing the different type of infection in food that is daily life. So we are trying to find out how we are going to manage this type of aflatoxin problem. And I'm working with the collaboration of IIT Guwahati and other institutes. So the application of nanotechnology in the food sciences, how we are going to utilize this nanotechnology in reduction of the
Is it confined to this region or general you are studying?
General.
Right.
This is some
okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
This is some award I get.
Right.
The DBT CUNY project to work on the TB and some other multi-drug resistant bacteria. I'm also working as a research plant evaluator for the Poland and the Switzerland. I'm working for as a
Right. Thank you. No, as you are, one of you can guide me. If some layman asks, sir, what is it NERIST has done for Northeast? One, students, of course, you are training them, you are encouraging them, they are getting educated, they are doing research. One benefit, no doubt. But in terms of general public, these are the crops, these are the modified crops, these are the diseases, these are the solutions. These are the new methods, agriculture implements, which we have suggested, which are being used. Aisa kuch hai kya?
Sir,
that's not your mandate.
Sir, regarding innovation, your specific curiosity, actually, for plant level, we have not come far away, but then for agriculture engineering, they have come out with some ergonomic advantages for the farmers and agriculture.
Have they become popular with the people?
Sir,
finding out something in the lab or in the university or the institute is one thing.
Sir,
study, you know, but it should become popular,
sir,
it should be useful to the people.
Sir,
nah?
To be honest, now we have come to a level when we are still live with our PhD and PhD program and with the research students. So now that part is going to happen within coming days.
Right.
Maybe within 1 or 2 years.
Next.
Sir, because initially we started with certificate board.
You understand. Next. Do you have anybody here, student, among the students who have been to a village, and what has been their experience? You yourself have gone. Which village?
Usually village.
Usually is a main, it's like, almost like a town, na?
They have
surrounding villages also.
So what you do? You are entering a village. What do you do? First step number one. Now, how do you? You go, you are not known in the village. How do you get the people? Do you take the help of local sarpanch? Do you take of some official? Or how do you get people? Or you go to each house? And how they, are they receptive? I'm trying to understand practically what is happening. Right. Anything more? Tell us.
We give cleanliness awareness program under dishwash bar and everyone. So these are some of the photographs which we have collected.
After the launch of Swachh Bharat, in the villages which we have gone, is there any improvement? Have they gone for toilets? Are they using money given by center and state government in constructing toilets? Have you seen anything? How they are functioning after construction, just construction, and then are maintained or not, as this aspect has been seen?
Sir, regarding this toilet and bathroom, after the construction, we have seen that they are been using properly, maintaining properly. They are well aware about the maintenance of this after handing over those to them.
How about water? Where do they get water? Toilet is constructed. Is water connection given or water has to be carried from a distance? What has been the practical experience?
Water, mostly here we use well water. So it is easily available. Water is lots, like water resources is lots.
All right. Okay. Thank you. Friends, frankly, I don't intend to make any speech. My purpose of going around, I have been in public life for 40 years. My purpose for going around the country is threefold. One, meet the researchers, find out what they are doing, how it is useful, is it reaching from lab to land, what are the challenges. Second, meet the students of various universities, understand what is happening in the universities, motivate them for their betterment and also for the betterment of the country. And the third, what are the gaps in these institutions and particularly related with agriculture? The very purpose of science is to make betterment of the human life. Science is not just to make a research and then find, publish a book and then feel happy. By inventing something, by finding something new, you must have value addition to the people, or you must reduce their difficulties, or you must reduce their expenditure, or you must guide them to go for new crops. These crops which you are producing are not useful. These crops will be more useful. Then these crops, you can go for value addition, food processing, or you can go for diversification. This region of this district in Arunachal is not good for paddy. Some other crop will be more useful. Bamboo cultivation, how value addition can be done. Like that, if the students and the researchers and their professors, they guide them and they come with some sort of new ideas. I will tell you how the new ideas are. One example, small. Prime Minister one day in the cabinet meeting asked, why this urea shortage every year, urea, fertilizer? Demand is increasing, sir. Farmers are using it more. Is it only that much or something else? And then he asked the minister, fertilizer minister, Anand Kumar, has the fertilizer production has come down or gone up? He said it has gone up, 245 million tons or something. So then why? Because I tell you, I became MLA in 1978. Since that year, every year I've been seeing and reading and experiencing urea shortage. Queue, line, waiting list, sometimes lottery charge. There was firing also in Gadak, in Karnataka. So what is happening? So PM said, come out with some ideas. Everyone have thought, what is the idea? Produce more. That's the one idea to end the shortage. So later, the Prime Minister himself, maybe through consultation, he came with an idea and said, urea is heavily subsidized by the government. And urea is used for farmers and also used by chemical factories. What you are subsidizing, you are not subsidizing to the farmer directly. You are subsidizing to the factory, which is producing urea. 1,000 tons I have produced, I claim, and then I am getting subsidy. So the alternative idea was to give subsidy directly to the farmer. To give subsidy directly to the farmer, you must have verification, you must have card, you must have the tahsildar, the local revenue fellow, everybody should cooperate with you. So PM came out with an idea. He said, this urea is being used not only for fertilizer, it is being used for chemical purpose for factory. Because you are using it, you are giving subsidy, the factory owners are showing 1,000 tons has been produced and giving much of it to the chemical factories. At the cost of government giving subsidy, they are selling it for private purpose. So he said, okay, do one thing. He said, add neem coating to the urea. We were surprised, even I am, with all the experience. Neem coating se hoga nahi. Kya hoga? Then neem coating urea is not fit for chemical factory purposes. So within few months, there is no urea shortage for last 2.5 years. No shortage, no waiting list, no brahman. Abundant is available to all the simple idea. Not a great research. There is some research, of course, neem coating. This may not be Prime Minister's invention. Somebody else might have found it also. But that's so some such new innovations, and also finding out what are the proteins, what are the other important things which will be useful. कुछ लोग हम लोग कुछ खाना खाते हैं ना बेकार खाते कुछ खाना में प्रोटीन होता है एडवांटेज होता है वी आर ईटिंग फूड विदाउट फाइबर आफ्टर पॉलिशिंग इट टू मच पॉलिश बिकॉज फैशन वी आर लूजिंग ऑल द मेन इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स दैट आर रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द बॉडी दिस आर ऑल थिंग्स दैट आर एक्सपेक्टेड फ्रॉम साइंस साइंस इज फॉर द बेटरमेंट ऑफ द पीपल सो इन वॉट वे we have bettered the living condition of the people. You people should pose that question to yourself and answer and move in future in that direction. Third, there is nothing wrong in finding out something and also publishing papers, research, and then publishing in the international magazines. That is also one part of the activity. Some of it you people are doing it also. And thirdly, education means knowledge. Importing knowledge is also an important thing. 1872 students of the Northeast coming here, staying here in the hostels and having a subsidized education is a good contribution to the very idea of setting up an institute here in the Northeast. The purpose is first to encourage the local students to get admission. Otherwise, these students would never have gone to Calcutta or Delhi or Mumbai to get admission in research and all. One. That was the purpose. That purpose is being achieved. The second purpose is techno. What is the requirement of technology for this region? Identify and then producing that technology. Third one is connecting with the life of the people. Exactly what are the problems? Erosion is there. Landslide is there. Is there a method to stop the landslides? One. So all these things has to be focused and it should be made people friendly, people use land, lab to land. That should be the focus. Secondary, gainful employment by your research. People should get something more than what they have been enjoying. And fourthly, what important thing that's missing in most of the institutes is we are not having regular touch with the real researchers. Who are the real research, according to me? I am a farmer. The farmers in the field, they have more knowledge than us. They don't have exposure to other things, machinery, technology, and other things. But they have knowledge because 50 years he has been a farmer. 50 years he has been rearing goats or sheep. 50 years he has been doing something, he and his father. Father might have told him something. So like that you would have. So if you interact with them, one, you will understand practical problems. Second, you will understand some of the knowledge and improve upon. It's called a skill upgradation. He has the skills and you have the technology. And if you combine together, you can upgrade the skills. This is how I want the scientific institutions to keep in touch. The other day I went to an agriculture college. I told them, the students during their course of 4-year study should spend minimum six months in the farmer's house. And he must get the signature of the farmer. That so-and-so student spent time in our village and he has spent time with me. That will get him additional marks, what you call as project report or whatever it is. Some such thing should be done. Otherwise, practical knowledge, practical experience, and practical utilization will not be there. This is the purpose. Friends, I am not a scientist. I can't speak much about what you have been doing. I just wanted to know what is happening. That's the purpose. I'm thankful for the director and also the board of management for providing me this opportunity to visit your institute and to know what is happening in this farthest region of the country, northeast. Thank you. Okay.
Thank you, sir, for your...
We will have a common group photo below.
Yeah, we can have it outside.
That's organize it and then call me. Call the students, one with the faculty, one with the students. This is done practically. There is no formalities of vote of thanks and all. And moreover, thanksgiving, they should not be combined with vote.
National anthem.
National anthem, okay.
All rise for the national anthem.